Hi everyone, it's Miss Maureen. Today we're going to make our very own drop boxes. So what you're gonna need is you're gonna need a box. Maybe a shoe box would be the best. I didn't have a shoe box, so I have this. You see that, how it has the rim around? You're gonna need one like that, okay? And one that you can easily sort of grab by both sides because you're gonna need to wiggle it to make your drop box. And then I just had markers and some fancy crayons. I just decorated however I wanted to. You could paint it. Of course, you'd have to wait for it to dry. That would be okay too. And then the other thing you're going to need is you're going to need something that rolls. Can you think of anything that rolls? Do you see anything in the background here that rolls? Do you see it? Yeah, it's the basketball. So, basketballs roll. That's a small one, you see it? But I feel like this is too big for my box that I have. See that? Because what you're going to have to do is you're going to have a grown-up make a hole in the box for you to fit whatever item you want to have in your drop box. So, the two items I picked today for my drop box is this little soft puck. It's a hockey puck. And this tiny little numbered car. The hockey puck doesn't really roll, but it sort of slides. You see that? Slides. So that I can use that too. And definitely the car. Do you think the car will roll? Let's see. The car will roll. All right, so you can pick where you want to put your hole. I'm gonna put my hole, I think, in the middle here, but you can put it anywhere, maybe like on one end or the other. Well, I'm gonna go with the end right here. Now this part is the part your grown-up should do. Use the scissors or a razor blade to cut out a circle. A razor would make a finer cut, obviously. I have a pair of scissors that I'm using. Cut it up, cut it off. Beautiful. And I'm going to hold it up and I'm going to show you the hole I made. See the hole? Okay. Since my box is falling apart, I need some of this tape. This is orange duct tape. I'm going to put it on here. And I'm going to put it on this end here because this end is falling apart. But once you have this made, I know you might need a grown-up to help you make it, but once it's made, you can use it. And you can keep it and you can use it again. It doesn't have to be made again. Especially if you reinforce the ends with some nice strong tape like I'm doing here, if it needs it. Some boxes are really strong. This one is not really that strong. All right, so let me show you what I have so far. See? See that? Can you see the hole? All right, now I'm gonna choose my item to put in and I'm gonna try to keep it from either falling in the hole or I can try to get it in the hole. Let's see. Let's try the car first. I'm gonna put it in. I'm gonna stand sort of with my feet apart, my arms nice and strong on either end, and I'm gonna roll it. I'm gonna try to get it in. Oh, no, it's not working. Oh, it dropped right out of the box, right out of my drop box. It rolled away. All right, I'm going to try the hockey puck now. See if I can get this hockey puck to stay in. Ooh.
Why brought it too?
Oh, no. Oh, that one fell right out. So there you go. Can you guys think of anything else you could put inside your drop box? What about those old pretend snowballs that some of us have? Or plastic balls or marbles? Anything you can think of that can kind of roll. And you can try to keep it from falling out of the hole, or you could try to get it in the hole. What do you think? Maybe if you had a long one like this, you'd have one person grab one end and one person grab the other. Oh, just an idea. Hope everybody's doing okay. Bye, everyone.